Hey guys, it's Jordy. Today's video is a little bit different. I'm actually going to be talking about how I got into YouTube and streaming and some tips for you guys if you ever want to get into it. I am by no means an expert. This is just my experience and some things that I've learned while doing it. So if you've ever thought about getting into content creation, just continue watching. But yeah. So this video is going to be kind of like two different parts. I'm going to talk about my backstory and how I got into everything, as well as answering some questions that I had on Instagram. So if you would like to check out my Instagram for potentially being in a part two to this video, please go follow me. If you do not want to hear my backstory, that's completely fine, I understand. You can skip to this timestamp, and this is where I start answering questions and giving some advice. I will also be drawing the thumbnail in the background for this video, so that's what you're gonna be seeing. If you ever want to see me do that in the future, just let me know. But yeah, let's get into it. So my entire content creation life actually started way back in 2018. I used to stream on Xbox, and for those of you who have an Xbox, you might know that there is a Twitch app, and it allows you to stream directly from the Xbox to Twitch. I don't know how it is now, but at the time there were some pros and cons. Cons being that you couldn't have any overlays, you couldn't have any alerts or anything like that. It was just straight up like the game you're playing. That was it. That was all you saw on the screen. On top of that, I don't think you could have a face cam unless you had like the Kinect camera when Kinect was a thing. But the pros were like you didn't need a computer. You could literally just stream right from the app itself. I don't know if you still can, but I just assumed one day I would start getting viewers. I didn't know how Twitch really worked. I kind of would just hit go live and that was it. So I think I was getting like 3 to 4 viewers at the time. And this is when I streamed Fortnite. Really into Fortnite back then. So I became friends with a bunch of other smaller streamers. The community thing just happens naturally. Eventually you'll have people start coming to your stream. You'll kind of form like a little community. So probably for about a year, I remained the same size. A lot of things were holding me back given that I was on Xbox. I didn't have a face cam. I had no overlays. I had no alerts. So fast forward to like June, July, 2019. This is where I became friends with Frizz and his group. I started playing Siege with him. This is when I got into Siege, and they were trying to convince me to do YouTube. I really didn't want to do YouTube. I thought it was too much work. I thought the editing was too much work, and I really just wanted to stick with streaming. This was when I also got my first PC. It was my first build. I built it myself. Very proud of it. But yeah, I just wanted to do streaming. I was convinced to do YouTube by a bunch of people. A lot of my friends can attest to this. I was very nervous about doing YouTube. I thought people weren't gonna like me. I thought I didn't have the personality for it. I thought I was too shy, too quiet. When I think of YouTuber personalities, I would think of like big, outgoing, sometimes obnoxious, very out there. And then, you know, there's me. I'm very quiet. I'm soft-spoken. I'm, you know, sometimes shy. So I was really worried that my personality and YouTube weren't gonna clash well. And I remember like asking to my friends, like, should I do this? Like, I don't think people are gonna like me. And they were like, shut up, you're stupid, just go for it. What's the worst that can happen? So I ended up doing it. My first video was posted September 21st. It actually got demonetized, so I ended up taking it down. That was my first video that I actually like edited and took the time on. And then my fourth video was Drunk Girls Play Siege. And that completely just went insane. I remember it was like mid-November when I posted that video. I had like 20,000 subs at the time. And a month later on Christmas Day, I hit 100K. And it was so weird. It was so weird. Like, you know, I was starting to get people saying they were like my biggest fans. And like, you know, I wasn't used to it. I was kind of like thrown into it. I didn't know what I was doing. I don't... Xbox me would be shitting her pants. Like, you know, sometimes when I'm streaming, I'll kind of just sit there and I'll look over and see like 300 viewers, 250 viewers, whatever. I'll kind of just be like, wow, like, holy shit. It was really weird going from a really small audience to a much bigger audience than what I was used to, especially. And that really showed in streaming too. Switching to PC helped a lot. I was starting to average like 15 to 20 viewers and sometimes like up to 30 on a really good day. But it did help a lot. But after summer was over, I went back to college, and at the time I did not have good internet, so I couldn't stream. So that's when I focused on YouTube. So that's when I put out my like my drunk video, my picking up guys video. And I went back home for Christmas break. You know, I was expecting the same 20 viewers. But when I started to stream, I remember having like 130. And I remember like kind of shitting my pants. But it was my first stream since really like doing YouTube. So I literally remember playing the game and like flexing my fingers because I was so nervous. Because I was not expecting so many people. You know, all of that was because of YouTube. You know, that would not have happened, at least not for a while, without YouTube. So I just kept going with it. I hit 100K Christmas 2020. This year I had like 270K or something like that for Christmas. But yeah, I just kept going with it over the course of the year. I kept doing YouTube. I kept streaming. I am so grateful to have such a good community. Like, I'm so happy that for the most part, everyone is extremely wholesome, extremely nice. Like, everyone is so welcoming. Like, I'm so happy that I met all of them, especially like the regular people. I'm so happy. And I'm so happy with what like we created. It's amazing. Anyways, mushy story over. I was very lucky when it came to YouTube. I honestly was not expecting to ever go past like 20,000 subs. And now we're at about 300,000. Like, that is insane. Like, I still cannot wrap my head around it. But yeah, thank you so much again for this journey and this experience. I'm gonna keep going. We'll see what happens. Yeah, let me answer some questions. The first question, I'm actually not gonna say this name because it's a little inappropriate, but Jack says, how hard is it to edit? I want to start YouTube. It's really not that hard once you get started, especially I feel like in our generations, we're definitely more, you know, tech savvy compared to like our parents, for example. I use Premiere Pro. I got it for free through my school, so definitely check with your school. You might actually get it for free and you don't know it. Otherwise, I think you can get a student license and it's like $20 a month. It's really not that hard. When you launch Premiere, there is a tutorial that kind of like goes over the user interface. Definitely recommend at least looking at that so you have an idea. There's also a ton of good tutorials on YouTube when it comes to subtitling and like editing, especially for like gaming or if you want to make montages and stuff like that. I think editing is more so the matter of, are you going to take the time and effort to learn it? Because the application won't do it all for you. You have to kind of know what you're doing. As long as you want it enough and want to learn it enough, you'll be fine. I promise it's not that hard. Once you start doing it, it's extremely easy. Next question, Dominique says, what inspired you to start YouTube? I actually wanted to do a singing like music channel for a long time, as well as like a drawing like sketchbook / art channel for a long time, but I wasn't really confident enough in my art or my singing to do any of that, so I never ended up doing it. But then I got into gaming a lot. I did actually consider doing YouTube when I was on Xbox, but I didn't know how to make videos when I was on Xbox because the only thing I could do was like clip with Cortana. I didn't know how I could do it on Xbox because I didn't have a capture card. I only had a MacBook at the time and it was like a dying MacBook because because I played CSGO on it and it killed it. Yeah, I didn't actually start until I got my first PC in the summer of 2019. I was convinced by a lot of people and I ended up doing it without any expectations, and here we are. So next question is from Daniel. He asks, what's the hardest thing about YouTube and Twitch? Two things. One of them being not letting stuff get to you, and that goes for anything. That goes for like comments, messages, views. I was so used to getting good views, and then I took like 40 days off of YouTube because I was sick. There's been a huge dip in my views because of it, all because I took a break. But it's okay. I'm just, you know, grinding my way back up to where I was. But just not letting stuff get to you in general is hard. Like, we're only human, you know. Sometimes, you know, for the most part, I let stuff kind of just like roll off my shoulders. I go with the flow for pretty much everything, but sometimes I'm having a bad day and I read the wrong comment or message, and it definitely gets to me sometimes. And I've said this so many times, but I read every single comment that I get on a video. A lot of you guys don't believe me when I say that, but I do genuinely read every single comment. The other thing is losing people I thought were my friends when I first started YouTube. And especially when I started to grow a lot, there were people who would be nice to my face and like say like, wow, congrats on everything. And then I would hear about them talking shit behind my back, saying I'll never make it, saying my videos suck, saying everything. Like, I remember a friend telling me that he watched my video on stream and that everyone loved it and blah, blah, blah. So I went to the stream to see their reactions. Like, I watched part of the VOD. And they were completely shitting on the video. Like, everything about the video, completely shitting on. You know, everyone, you know, people's videos aren't for everyone. I completely understand that. But they were just being mean, like just outright mean. And then for him to say like, hey, I watched your video on stream today, like everyone loved it. Like, it was really disheartening to see. You know, I was excited to see their reactions, and then to pretty much get shit on was really like, okay. So I pretty much cut off everyone that wasn't a good friend when I was growing. I don't wish anything bad on them or anything like that. It's just one of those things, like, it kind of shows you true colors, I guess. So Next question is from ANOC Gaming. I don't know if I said that right, but they asked, how do you keep from being boring? Because when I'm not playing with my friends, I'm very boring. I struggle with the same exact thing. I still don't think I have the personality when it comes to streaming or YouTube. I do worry sometimes I'm not good enough and I'm boring, but you cannot have that mindset. People are gonna like you for you. You know, for the most part, people are gonna watch you because they like your personality, not because of who you play with or who you surround yourself with. If they stick around, it's because of you. It's not because of anyone else. It's all because of you. Try not to think like that. Your personality will speak for itself. And yeah, that's basically it. The next question is from Truly Azina. Her question is, how did you start streaming / making content being a girl? I want to do it so much when I'm shy. I was the same exact way, Azina. I am not an outgoing, loud person. I'm pretty reserved. I'm pretty quiet. Streaming and doing YouTube has definitely made me 10 times more confident. I have no problem talking to a stream with 300 people, and back in the day I would get nervous about streaming to 30 people. It definitely makes you more confident. I highly encourage you to try it if you haven't already. From the way you worded your question, I don't know if you're nervous about making videos and like actually getting content, like actually going into lobbies and using your mic and stuff like that. I still get nervous doing that when I'm by myself and I need to talk in a lobby. I get nervous doing that, you know, especially in COD. Like, COD is very like unforgiving. So I still get nervous. You kind of just have to do it, you know. At the very least, you'll get someone who is a dick to you and you can clip it and put it in a video. If you're more comfortable, you can always make a group of girlfriends and just play with them. That way you're not always surrounded by men. yeah, I definitely encourage you to try it. You know, it definitely helped me become more confident, and I think it would help you too. So yeah, I hope it goes well. The next two questions are from Isabella. She has two, and I think they're both good questions. The first one is, how to make friends in the content making community. That stuff kind of just happens naturally. You know, I've become friends with people who literally just DM me and say, hey, do you want to play sometime? And I say, yeah. Other times it's either through friends of friends. My first YouTuber friend was my friend Gabe. He goes by Tabutter on YouTube. He's a CSGO YouTuber. I met him because I would tweet him a picture of me playing CSGO on my MacBook and like say, like, play with me or something. And we ended up becoming friends. Another person was Soft Willy. He's like a Discord YouTuber. I ended up meeting him because he got a sponsor offer that was awful, and I got the same exact offer. So I ended up replying to one of his tweets saying I got the same thing, and we ended up becoming friends. And I actually asked him for a lot of advice when it came to YouTube because I was very new at it. And I also ended up meeting Isaac through Nick. So a lot of it's either through friends of friends or just by flat out asking. You know, and that does not mean spam, you know, your favorite YouTubers' DMs at all. Please do not do that. On top of that, just being active in their community. There are some people who are in my Discord or my Twitch that I now consider friends. You know, it can happen in different number of ways. Her next question was, any advice you would give to people who are just starting out? There are two things I can say when it comes to this. If there is anything that you should listen to out of this video, listen to these two tips. Number one, make sure you have like a brand. Make sure you have a good username. So if your username is like johnsmith867500, that is not a good username. You know, having a clean username with like not a lot of numbers and something that just is, you know, kind of catchy. I know there are sites where you can like have like a username generator if you don't know what to do. You know, have a logo and don't copy a bigger streamer's logo, because, you know, for example, like Ninja, you know, everyone knows him from this logo. And if you copy it, people are gonna look at it and think Ninja, not whoever you are. So have emotes, have sub badges, you know, take advantage of what you can do on Twitch. And on top of that, start a TikTok. TikTok is extremely, extremely easy to grow on. It is so easy to go viral on there. Try to stand out from other TikToks as well. Sounds tedious, but subtitles really do help. They really push, you know, whatever the conversation is or whatever the joke is. It does help. You know, TikTok is so easy to grow on. Just start posting your clips, use the hashtags. I can't even tell you how many times I've been told like, hey, I'm here from TikTok. And I can't tell you how many videos I've seen on TikTok where it's like, you know, a video of someone showing their setup and saying I'm a new streamer, but no one comes to my stream, you know, and it's a viral video, and then I'll go to their stream and they have like 10,000 followers, all because of TikTok. So definitely take advantage of TikTok. TikTok is just sitting there waiting for you to use it if you don't already. So the biggest thing is branding, or like at least growing another social media. So whether it's TikTok, Instagram, Twitter, YouTube. Like, the whole reason my Twitch does well is because of YouTube and because of TikTok. Those were the best places when it came to like traffic and stuff like that. But yeah, those are the top two things I can recommend for you. That is all I'm going to talk about in this video. I talked quite a bit. I'm sorry if I rambled. Thank you so much for sticking around and listening if you made it this far. If you would like a part two or want more information on a certain topic, let me know in the comments. I would not mind making another video like this. I actually enjoy talking videos the most on my channel. Please subscribe if you are not already. I would majorly appreciate it. Yeah, just let me know and I will see you guys next time. Bye guys!